okay, so I'm going to go back there. He's going to get the incense. And then just, I'll look through there. And then I'll give you the thumbs up that we're going to go through the stuff, okay?
We welcome everybody to St. Margaret Mary Catholic Church for the celebration of the first Sunday of Advent at the beginning of the liturgical year. We invite everyone to please stand to begin the celebration. This wreath has been placed in our sanctuary to remind us that we are beginning a journey that will call us to be transformed and prepared to receive Christ, who is King of heaven and earth. Lord our God, your church joyfully awaits the coming of its Savior, who enlightens our hearts and dispels the darkness of ignorance and sin. Loving God and Father, we praise you for your Son, Jesus, who is the Christ, the King of heaven and earth. He is Emmanuel, the hope of the peoples. He is the wisdom that teaches and guides us. He is the Savior of every nation. Author of life, let your blessing come upon us as we gather around this wreath and its light. May the wreath and its light be a sign of Christ's promise to bring us salvation. May you come quickly and not delay. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
grant your faithful, we pray. Almighty God, the resolve run forth to meet your Christ, our King, with righteous deeds at his coming, so that, gathered at his right hand, we may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
To you. said to his disciples, "Be watchful, be alert. You do not know when the time will come. It is like a man traveling abroad. He leaves home and places his servant in charge, each with his own work, in order to the gatekeeper, be on watch. Watch, therefore. You do not know when the Lord of the house is coming, whether in the evening or at midnight or at the cockcrow or in the morning. May he not come suddenly and find you asleep. What I say to you, I say to all, watch." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated.
To all of you who are joining us via Facebook and YouTube, I want to take a moment to introduce myself to all of you. I'm Father Jimmy Brennan. I'm the pastor of St. Margaret Mary Catholic Church in the Archdiocese of San Antonio, Texas. And on behalf of our deacon, Deacon Greg Wick, and our entire parish community, we welcome you in the celebration of the Eucharist and this moment, this first Sunday of Advent, in which we, here at St. Margaret Mary, and the church throughout the entire world, enters into the new liturgical year, the Year of Grace 2021. For those of y'all who are here in the church and were with us this past weekend, you remember that we celebrated last Sunday the Solemnity of Christ the King, in which we in the church celebrated in honor the deepest held belief in our Roman Catholic Christian tradition that Christ will come again. He will come again at a moment we do not know. And he will return as our King. Now we know that the image we were given of the kingship of Christ this past Sunday was that of the Good Shepherd, the one who shepherds his flock as a sacrificial shepherd, giving his life one who seeks out the lost, the abandoned, one who heals the wounded, and one who brings eternal life for those who have died. We celebrate this image of Jesus as our King. So we ended the liturgical year with a hope that the Lord Jesus would come back again and take us all to himself. And it did happen. Yet. But remember, as we heard in today's gospel, no one of us knows the day, the hour, the moment when we will stand before the King, either when he comes back to us or when we go to him. There will be that moment of reunion. And so Holy Mother Church begins the liturgical year in the energy, the same excitement, the same focus. In the first and second Sunday of Advent, the church calls us to be prepared not for Christmas, but for the second coming of Christ, and to help us focus on the image of Christ returning as King. The church allows us to place within the sanctuary this wreath, which is a symbol of a crown, the crown of victory won by Christ through his death and resurrection. The symbol of a crown has been in the church since the time we look for the coming of the newborn King, born of Joseph and Mary in Bethlehem of Judea. The image of the crown remains in the church as we honor and celebrate the epiphany of Christ as a light to all nations. And of course, no one of us will ever forget the crown that Christ would wear upon his head when he hung upon the cross. We were reminded that this is the King of the Jews. This is our King, one who is willing to give his life for us. The church again went through the rhythms of times and seasons to celebrate Christ the King. And here we are, the first Sunday crown is placed in our midst to remind us that we are still awaiting the King. The lights that are placed upon the wreath are images for us of the light of Christ coming into our life. It moves us through the 4 Sundays of Advent, allowing us to remember and prepare for His second coming. Honor that with the first 2 candles, and then with a peak, we joyfully begin to remember that Christ was indeed born in Bethlehem of Judea, and we are drawn to prepare ourselves for His first coming, when He was born of Joseph and Mary. So it's about being prepared. That's what Advent is. It is a wonderful season of preparation. And Jesus, in today's gospel, put it in a nutshell. He actually gave us probably one of the clearest and most concise presentations of what we should be about. I remember my freshman year, right after graduating from high school, my freshman year at San Antonio College, I took a speech course. And I was, who else went to San Antonio College? Raise your hands. Be proud, people. It's a great school. So I went to SAC, and I remember while I was at SAC, the speech teacher told us, when you're giving a speech, there is no greater presentation of anything than this simple method. And Jesus is the one who gave it to us. Tell people what you're going to tell them. Then tell them. And then, at the end, tell them what you told them. So think about that. Tell them what you're going to tell them. Tell them. And then tell them what you told them. So what Jesus in today's gospel said was very clear. Watch and be ready. Because at a moment you do not know, the Lord is going to come. And then he gives us this beautiful story of a man who leaves his household. And the people there do not know when he returns. Whether he returns at early evening or at midnight at the top floor. No one knows the moment that he will return. But the coming of the Son of Man will be just like that. And then at the end he says, what I tell you is this. Watch. He wants us to be actively engaged in our faith, to be living it out, living life to the fullest. And he wants us to remember that watching is not a passive experience, but it is an active experience. It's one that actually engages every aspect of who we are, our memory, our being, our entire soul. We put everything we have and everything we are in being prepared for the Lord's coming. Now, this year has done something for all of us. It has reminded us, with a pandemic that is sweeping across the entire world, just how fragile life is, and how unexpected any one of us could face the experience of going home to God. It reminds us of how important it is for us to live life to the fullest while always being faithful to what we believe. It's not either or, it's both at all. Can you imagine? Sister Rosemary Rockhead, a good shepherd sister who's one of my dearest friends, reminded me of that. She says, Father, it's not just about that, but it's about the experience here on earth as well. Now, of course, she would explain it to me at a Mexican restaurant when we were sitting down to a big tray of nachos and 2 big plates of Mexican food.
We are going to eat, and she says, Father. And she hits me. Pop. She goes, Father, all of this and heaven too. And then we ate. all of this in heaven too. Because you see, it's not one or the other, it's both and all. Today's first reading reminds us all that we need to be transformed, that there are things in our lives that we need to reshape and we need to refashion. And Isaiah reminds us of that. And then he concludes today's first reading with this image. You are the potter, and we are the clay, the work of your hands. So during this year, with the loss of so many of our family and friends through not only COVID, but through other experiences, I began to think about that image. God is the potter, and we are the clay. We are the work of his hands. Because you see, I have celebrated funeral services for babies, for small children, for teenagers, for young adults, and for people who have lived what seems to be five lifetimes in their 90s and in their hundreds. And each one of those remind me of how the potter shapes our life and allows us to become exactly what he wants of us, regardless of how long we live in the world that we have. For some, it will be a few weeks, and they will be shaped into a vessel in the image and likeness of God. For others, it'll just be a couple of years. But what the potter does in those years is incredible. For another, she may be 17. And what the Lord God has shaped in that vessel, 1,000 more years could not improve upon it. A thousand more years could not have shaped anything more beautiful than that 17-year-old daughter, Natalie. Whether we are in our 20s, our 40s, our 60s, or we have gone past our 80s, the Lord God, the potter, shapes and fashions each of us into this incredible vessel. And within that time that we are given, we grow in the fullness of life. And we are drawn home to eternity. So whether we are here in the church or in our homes or somewhere else on earth, when the Lord comes in his second coming, we need to be ready. We need to watch and be prepared. Or whether we have gone home, in whatever year we have achieved in this earth, the Lord, the potter, the author of life, has brought our family home to the eternal dwelling place, to be in the presence of the King. So remember, all of us, we must be faithful to our relationship with God and live life to the fullest. Because at an hour we do not know, either he's coming to us or we're going to him. So he calls us this day and every day to watch. my friends, gathered together around the light of the Advent wreath, we bring forth the prayers, the needs of all people, and we proclaim what we hold and believe. As we begin this year of grace, I would ask that as you proclaim your faith, you participate in a beautiful tradition, one of proclaiming an oath by raising your hand as you respond with the words, I do, to all that Holy Mother Church asks of us. And so I ask you, do you believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and of earth? Do you believe in Jesus the Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body and of life everlasting? My friends, this is our faith. This is the faith of the church, and we are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Loving God, hear now the prayers that we bring forth, the prayers of the members of our parish community and for the flock around the entire world. You turn the mic on.
That world leaders may hear the cries of those in need, the poor, the homeless, the persecuted, and the broken, and see the face of the Lord in their suffering, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those around the world who suffer from HIV, AIDS, that they may know the tender compassion of the presence of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those in our community who receive plenty to eat on Thanksgiving from our generosity, but struggle to feed their families and themselves every other day, that they may be remembered throughout the year, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. Loving and faithful God, we turn to you with these, our prayers and our needs, and ask that you grant them through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's be seated. I would like to just take a moment to thank all of you who are present here for the generosity you have shown to St. Margaret Mary in our collections. This helps the mission and ministry of our parish. And again, I thank you very much for your generosity. And for all of those who are joining us via Facebook and YouTube, remember, you can use at this time one of the applications, the apps that are found on our Facebook site. And we ask that you be very generous in helping us support the mission and ministry of St. Margaret Mary Parish. Thank you very much for your generosity.
Comfort, comfort, O my people, speak of peace, now says our God. Comfort those who live in darkness, mourning neath their sorrow's load. Speak unto Jerusalem of the peace that waits for them. Tell of all the sins I cover, and that warfare now is over. Of one who's crying in the desert far and near, bidding all to for repentance, since the kingdom now is here. Oh, that warning cry obey, now prepare for God away. Let the valleys rise to meet him, and the hills bow down to greet him.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept his sacrifice
at your hands
for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ, our Lord and Holy Redeemer. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which we now dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it. Giving it to his disciples, he said, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. My Lord and my God. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. My Lord and my God. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we might be drawn together as one in the unity of the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Gustavo, our Archbishop, and all the clergy and religious. Remember your daughter, and our sister, Natalie Marissa Rodriguez, whom you have received from this life to yourself. Grant that she, who is united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in the hope of rising. Bring them and all of the departed into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and martyrs, Blessed Saint Joseph, the husband of Mary, Blessed Saint Margaret Mary, and all of your saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son and our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. My friends, let us stand, for at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await in joy-filled hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus who is the Christ. For the kingdom,
the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, and my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. As we bow to one another, let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world, Jesus the Christ. He who has revealed the love, the compassion, and the grace of the Father. He, the King of glory, in whose advent we gather. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof.
But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Just want to remind everybody, for the reception of Holy Communion, we will form a single line down the center of the aisles, using the yellow marks on the floor to help create social distancing between individuals and families. We ask that as you come forward, you leave your mask on, covering your nose and your mouth. You will receive the Eucharist, the bread of life, in your hand. You may step to the side and then remove the mask, consume the Eucharist, repose your mask, and then return to your pew. I will be here in the center of the church. The deacon will begin on this side over here. After he completes just this side chapel, he will come over to the other side chapel. And anyone unable to come forward, myself or the deacon will go to you. And we thank you very much for your patience and consideration during this procession. And those of you all joining us via Facebook and YouTube, please join us in a spiritual communion. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
somebody. One Lord of all. One cup of blessing which we bless. And we, though many, Gentile or Jew, servant or free, woman or man, no more one.
Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and to hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Linda?
Just real quick, I want to invite our Director of Youth Ministry and CCD Faith Formation to come forward, Linda Rubio. She has a great announcement and a wonderful opportunity for all of us to engage in and during this Advent season.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, Miss Linda.
Guys, So our Faith Formation Catechist thought of a great way for all of our families to gather at home, because a lot of us are watching Mass online, and or take it to our families, or take this. We're selling Advent wreaths, so you could take home with the three purple candles and the one rose candle for $5 only. They are miniature, but if you feel that this is something you would really benefit at home, look into getting a bigger one. And we also made little nativity scene blocks as well for also $5. They were a big hit at our last Mass, so we are a little bit more limited today. A lot of families have found they want to take them to other family members as well. So we will be here next week as well selling them if we cannot get you one today. If you haven't registered your little ones for CCD yet, you can still register them at stmmcc.org under our Faith Formation tab. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And I want to remind you that the church holds and teaches that the most fundamental and basic experience of church occurs in the home. Saint John Paul II, our former pope, reminded us that the home is the domestic church. It is where we experience the wonderful gift of our Christian identity day by day with the family and friends who come into our homes. So please take part in this wonderful opportunity to engage the home as the domestic church. I would also like to remind everybody that even with this pandemic, we are choosing to make sure that we celebrate both the Advent and the Christmas seasons with great dignity. And so we are asking all of you to begin to think ahead. Next weekend, we are going to start taking donations for the poinsettias. These are the Christmas flowers we use to decorate the church. If you would like to just at home in an envelope, make a donation. And if you would like to write who would you like it would be, maybe in memory of someone who has died or in honor of someone who is experiencing a wonderful event in their life. This is a great thing for you to do, and I will read each of these and keep them in prayer as we celebrate the Christmas liturgies, and the flowers will adorn the sanctuary. Again, we are doing that this coming weekend and the weekend following. I'd also like to note in the next week or two, guess what Father Jimmy's gonna be doing? He is gonna be asking for donations of Christmas trees. We remember we decorate the church sanctuary, the nativity and everything with Christmas trees. And I always ask for donations of the Christmas trees. So begin thinking which families are able to this year purchase a Christmas tree. And then all of us will be able to volunteer and help decorate the church on the last Sunday of Advent. So again, this is a great way to buy a tree in memory of someone who has died, and also in honor of some great event happening in your life. And remember, our loved ones going home to heaven is a great event. It is a great event knowing that our families who have left us here on earth are at home with Christ in heaven. So those of y'all who are watching us on YouTube and Facebook, remember, I'll be asking you for a donation as well. So please make sure you're all ready to help me with that in the coming weeks. Thank you very much. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessings from the divine light of this Advent wreath descend upon each of you, the blessings of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace and be watchful.
Thanks be to God.